Hello friends, today we would be doing the very famous Benedict's test for sugars. The principle behind this test is that when reducing sugars are heated in the presence of an alkali, they are converted into enediols, which reduces the cupric compounds present in the Benedict's reagent to cuprous compounds, which then get oxidized to form the cuprous oxide. This test is actually a semi-quantitative test, which means the color of the precipitate would give us an idea about the concentration of the reducing sugar present in it. Now, let us see the materials required. We require glucose solution or any other reducing sugar and Benedict's reagent. First of all, we will take a test tube into which we will be adding 5 ml of the Benedict's reagent. You can see that Benedict's reagent have a blue color because of the presence of copper sulfate in it. The components of Benedict's reagent are copper sulfate, sodium citrate, and sodium carbonate. Now, after taking the 5 ml solution, we add 8 drops of glucose solution. This test is used in biochemistry for the identification of sugar in urine. If you are using urine, then also you will be adding 8 drops of urine into the Benedict's reagent. After adding the sugar into the reagent, we will mix it well and we will heat the contents to boil it. A word of caution while using a test tube. Always heat the test tube with the help of a test tube holder and keep the test tube in a slanting position, and the mouth of the test tube should be away from you or any other person standing near you, because you don't want the solution to bump out of the test tube and splash it all over you. And also while heating it, intermittently shake the test tube so that the heat is evenly spread in the test tube. Otherwise, the bottom portion will get heated up and it can cause an increase in pressure in the test tube, causing the contents to bump out. You can see that when the solution has started to boil a little, there is a color change. Initially, you see a green color, and then you can see a yellow precipitate-like thing forming on the top. Slowly, that yellow color is changing into an orange color, and finally you get the brick red color. In the Benedict's test, the brick red color is the color that you can obtain with the maximum concentration of reducing sugar in it. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you loved the content of this video, do click on the subscribe button and the bell button if you want to get notified about my new videos.